In this video, I'm going to be talking about the different types of music video. Pop music videos can be filmed anywhere and have multiple locations, but many are typically filmed in a studio, with the band or artist miming in front of a green screen. An example of this is Katy Perry's Unconditional, which has been filmed in a main hall of a manor or castle. In the video, there are many different costumes for Katy and the actors, or dancers. The guys are wearing military uniforms, whilst the girls are wearing long dresses. This gives the appearance of a military ball. Whilst Katy is wearing a white dress at the beginning of the video, which blends in quite well with the scene, as she is outside while it appears to be snowing. The scene changes to Katy in a main hall, wearing a black dress with a glittery silver pattern. The scene changes once again, this time to Katy in a red dress with a gold pattern. Throughout the music video, the scene then flashes between the black and silver dress and the red and gold dress. In my opinion, the video doesn't really suit the lyrics. The lyrics are about loving someone unconditionally and just caring about someone. This makes the video uninterpretive. In Katy Perry's Unconditional, one of the main props is, at the beginning of the video, the falling snow. The snow is normally only used in pop videos and sometimes Christmas songs to add that scent to give the music video a Christmassy feel. The lighting in the video remains light throughout the video. By this, we can tell that the mood in the music is light and pleasant. The editing in the video starts off slow, but the scene changes get faster with the beat of the song, with the scene cut into Katy and the dancers. Camera movements are mainly a mix of close-ups and mid-shots, mainly of Katy, as well as the one or two shots of the dancers. The camera also zooms in and out of the scenes to show us what's going on around Katy. Rock music videos are filmed anywhere relevant to the song, such as an abandoned building. Most of the time they are filmed in a studio or a stage which has been set up where the band are performing in front of an audience, with effects added after filming. An example of this is Linkin Park's Burn It Down, which features the band performing in an abandoned place with computer graphics over the top. The band is wearing dark clothes throughout the video. This adds to the stereoism we have with rock bands. The lyrics have numerous interpretations. The main interpretations seem to be about building an artist or a band up, and they become famous and popular one minute, but the next thing you know, they've either done something wrong, or there's a bad rumour going around and everyone starts hating the artist. So the video sort of fits in to the lyrics, but not much, making this video also uninterpretive. The main props just mainly seem to be the instruments, although there are what seem to be cables on the set. The lighting is low throughout the video, however at certain points in the video you can see light coming through what appears to be windows. The video begins with a pan shot before cutting to a mid close-up shot and then a wide angle shot of the band. This occurs throughout the video, along with a few close-ups of the rappers. The editing, the cuts between the scenes, is fast and continuous, following on each of the band members at a time. Throughout the video, we've seen the band members glowing blue in time to the pace of the music. And at a certain point of the video near the end, we see stills of the band on fire with pieces of debris all hitting them. Alternative music videos are completely different from mainstream music. An example of this is Radioactive by Imagine Dragons. Alternative music videos have no set locations or specifics. This video is set in a fight club, but with a difference. Instead of people or animals fighting, it's stuffed toys, which add a comical effect to the video. The costumes are different for each actor, and band member. The girl who enters the fight club at the beginning of the video is wearing a blue hoodie, as is the singer in the band, and the other band members are in casual clothes, such as jeans and t-shirts, whereas the guys in the fight club themselves who are watching it are wearing cowboy hats and everyday clothes, apart from the head guy in the white blazer and trousers. Because of this outfit and the fact that he's higher than the spectators, it's clear that he's in charge. The lyrics have multiple meanings. Many believe it is to do with post-apocalypse. The Dan Reynolds, lead singer in the band, is about him overcoming his depression. I believe the lyrics are about doing something new and seeing life in a new way. However, the video doesn't really fit in the lyrics. But it does tell a story, which makes the video a narrative. There are quite a few props in this video, such as the stuffed animals or puppets, the money that is thrown around, and the key that the man in charge wears around his neck. The lighting throughout the video is very light, but only in the fight club, giving the appearance of daylight. But in the dungeon where the band members are, it's very dark and cold looking. There are many different camera shots in this video, starting off with a very long shot and then moving to medium close-up and the pan of the band members. This changes throughout the music video, however. But the video itself is a mix of medium long shots, mid shots, close-ups and extreme close-ups. The editing is fast between cuts, mainly cutting from Fight Club to the dungeon below, as well as the purple monster and his opponents, to the losing puppet, or toy, being sent to the dungeon. Live concerts give the fans the chance to see their favourite band performing live. This turns the song into an event. An example of this is Swedish House Mafia, Don't You Worry Child. At the beginning of the video, a newsreader is saying how the Swedish House Mafia are playing one last time in the UK. It features the band playing live in a huge gig. Animation, or stop animation, is putting lots of images together to create movement. An example of this is I'm Walking in the Air from The Snowman. This video is also a narrative because it's telling a story. The snowman and the boy are flying to a forest somewhere in the Arctic. The film was produced using traditional animation techniques consisting of pastels, crayons and other colouring tools drawn on pieces of celluloid, which are traced over hand-drawn frames. For continuing purposes, the background artwork was painted using the same tools. I'm holding very tight. I'm riding in the moon. Homage is when the music video acknowledges something historical. An example of this is On Top of the World by Imagine Dragons. In the video, the band members are the astronauts who go up to the moon. The video also includes clips from the actual moon landing, but it also plays on the theory that the moon landing was faked by the government. A pastiche music video copies the style of another piece of artistic works. There are two types of pastiche: general, in which the music video is more serious than parody, and hodgepodge, which is a mix of different styles copied into the music video. An example of this is Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen. Parody, or musical parody, is the copying or changing of existing music. Parody is normally used to create humour, but its main feature is copying music. An example of this is Love the Way You Lie, which was originally performed by Skylar Grey. However, there has been numerous copies. One of the most famous copies was performed by Eminem and Rihanna. However, I can't get the video for this, so I'm afraid we'll have to make do with the original sung by Skylar. But you'll always be my hero, even though you've lost your mind. Just gonna stand there and watch me burn. Well, that's alright, because I like the way it hurts. Just gonna stand there and hear me cry. Well, that's alright. Inspirationist music videos are when the music video takes inspiration from different sources. An example of this is War by 30 Seconds to Mars. The video features the band dressed as soldiers in desert uniform. It also contains clips from famous speeches such as JFK and Martin Luther King Jr., as well as quotes at the beginning of the video. To me, the video states that we should have peace. The video shows all the military vehicles, tanks, helicopters, cars, and even ships being dragged into a mound, which is revealed to be a triangle. This is also the band's logo.
To the soldier, the civilian, the martyr, the victim, this is war.
Surrealist music videos are just weird music videos in general. An example of this is Close Enemies by Example. To me, the video is just weird. You have Example wandering around what appears to be a prison with fears in cells. It's just weird, there's no point to it, and it just doesn't fit in with the lyrics or anything to do with the song. You buried all my words with a shovel. Your smile should have told me your trouble.